One of the basic operations of the school is to profanate the world. So to profanate means to take something out of its regular use and to bring it into the school so that it can get a new use. So it is taken out of its regular use and it's opened up for a new use. That's a profanation. That's a school operation. You could say that today we have this operation of profanation in a massive way. So you could say that the internet, or maybe better, the World Wide Web, the World Wide Web is offering us a totally profanated world, in the sense of you can find everything, but everything without history or without context or without, so it's just there, it's available. So that's, I think, a very important thing to notice, that in a certain sense the World Wide Web in itself realizes one important aspect of school. It profanates the world and it offers the world in a public way, it's unprecedented. So if the things are taken out of their regular use and they are offered free of out of that context, they can easily be taken up in a market logic. So they are available, so you can sell them, you can buy them, they can be submitted under the laws of the market. But the operation of profanation is just one aspect of the school. There is that second, or at least a second operation, is in a certain sense, so to profanate and then to make something speak again. So to make that it is not just available in the sense that I can do what I want with it, but that the direction is changed and that something also starts to speak again to me, so that it is not all available, but that I feel obliged to something, and that is related to what the school is doing when it is creating a kind of attention or kind of relationship to the world. And this relationship to the world, I think, is also important to have a feeling of reality. Yes? To have a feeling of something really matters. Yeah. And related to that feeling of really, of existing, because there is something that really matters, and therefore I feel that I exist because I have a relationship to something that is really mattering, I think that today that is another element which is also related to the, and especially to the social media, not only to the social media, is that it seems that the experience of the real and the experience of that I exist, that this experience is now more and more depending on the fact that I am publicly recognized. And recognized in the double sense, so in the sense of I know you and I like you. If the feeling of existence is related to this recognition, I need a space, a stage where I can be visible so that I can be seen and can be recognized. So I have to go on the stage. And there I have to offer my profile, or I make my profile, I'm profiling myself, in order to make me known and to look for recognition. So it means that I am constantly looking for a connection, because I need this stage to have the feeling that I'm living, so I need to be connected to that stage all the time. I have to monitor my profile all the time. I have to upload and to look at what others, how they react and how I can deal with that on this stage. But it means also that we are becoming very, very dependent on this kind of recognition. So our existence is very, very much depending on this kind of recognition. And so instead of offering us a kind of freedom, because it is often said that these virtual profiles, that they allow us a certain freedom in saying, in showing who we are, we can have different kinds of profiles. You could say that, in fact, it's the way around, that these profiles and the way we construct these profiles become important for who we are. So, and we come in a situation of dependence and not of freedom. And in this context, and it is related to the fact that we have to be visible all the time. So not visible in the sense of in the streets, but visible on this virtual meet, in this virtual world, or this virtual stage. So, and I just want to remind, so there is the point of the dependence, constant being dependent there and not free, being feeling uncertain, asking constantly for feedback, looking constantly to have a reaction on the profiles. There is one thing that I wanted to point to is that the text of Hannah Arendt on the crisis of education is a text that meanwhile is very, very, very popular. But I don't think you see often the reference to what Hannah Arendt is saying. At some point, she's saying that in order to have the possibility for youngsters to be able to form themselves, to educate, and to be educated, and to educate themselves, they have, in some sense, to be protected from the light of being permanently visible. And she gives the example of the children, the daughters and the sons of famous movie stars. So, of course, our text is in the 60s, it is old, but she's referring to examples where these children get totally spoiled, so to say, and where they really have very bad futures. And she relates it to the fact that they are exposed to the public, and so not protected against the public, but constantly living a public life or a visible life. So in order to be able to form ourselves, we also need a certain invisibility, yes, a certain protection against the visibility. And yeah, that is something that I think I would like to emphasize, this element of the need to be protected against the light. And maybe could translate that in the need for caves. Not in the literal sense, but in the sense that we need spaces which are dark, so, and where the light is limited to the light that is helping us to see something and not see ourselves, or not be seen ourselves.